name's Roger Collins. I'm a guitar player. I'm going to play a few songs for you here. This first one is a piano tune that I've always loved. It's a wonderful tune. Never really heard anybody do it on the guitar, but since I don't play piano, we'll do it on the guitar. It's called Last Date. Here's a song called Steel Guitar Rag. Thank you. This is called Windy and Warm.
Hi, I'm Michael Smith with Elk Talk. Tonight I have a very special guest. I have Nadia Noel with the University of Nevada Cooperative Extension?
University of Nevada Reno Extension. We rebranded.
Oh, well, yeah. I did not know that.
It's okay. No one does.
The reason this topic is so important to me is when I first moved to Tahoe, I think about 12 years ago, or I've been here a little while, but about 12 years ago, the city of South Lake Tahoe did a program about lead paint, and then also radon got involved, and I think we had something else involved too, asbestos or something. So for TV, we had my two little cabins tested. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know anything about radon. I didn't even hear about it. I was just trying to do something for public TV. Mm-hmm. Well, our house became twice as high as the, what's legal, I guess, or safe. So we had, it got mitigated, and then no big deal, it was back to being a safe house. And then, I had a stroke and I had some health changes, so I moved to an apartment building, and there a lot of people were getting cancer. And mm-hmm. I thought, so when the latest person, like 18 people, mm-hmm. so when the 18th person got cancer, and I'd been there about 3 years, I gave her one of these kits right here to test her house, test the apartment building, and it came back positive, again, very high. So we tested the place twice, and we got mitigation for that place. Mm-hmm. But I still got lung cancer. Mm-hmm. And then last year when we did the lecture at the TRPA offices, what, on Market Street, you gave me some more kits, and I gave it to a lot of my family and friends, and a lot of them are getting mitigated too. Mm-hmm. And there's so many people now that are getting mitigated for their radon that the guy who puts in the mitigation
systems,
it's too busy to be on the show. His name is Norm Denny down here in Carson Valley and in surrounding areas. And then the people we used up in my house on Aspenwald and the Skyforce Apartments on Emerald Bay Road was called Environment Inspections. And I think his last name was Gorman. And he's at www.TahoeRadon.com. So these are guys that could fix your property. And Norm, you can check him out at 775-691-7131. And then for education, we got her to tell you, I already told you why it's important, because you might get sick. Mm-hmm. And she's going to tell you the initial history of all this.
Yeah, so radon's a radioactive gas that comes from the ground. It comes from the breakdown of uranium, which is in dirt and rocks. And so over time, uranium breaks down to be radon gas, and it gets trapped in buildings and homes, and that's where we're breathing it in. And if we're exposed to elevated levels of radon, which would be 4 picocuries per liter of air or higher, that increases the chances that we can get lung cancer. And this is because radon is radioactive, and that radiation can damage our lung cells in two ways. One, it could kill our lung cells, which sounds alarming, but isn't as big a deal as damaging our lung cells' DNA. And when that happens, that's where lung cancer can form, because if you know anything about cancer, if there's a cell with damaged DNA and it's able to reproduce itself, that's how it can form cancer in the lungs.
Well, what kind of shocked me was my apartment and the place that, the other apartment that had tested, and even my cabins, these were all pretty breathable places. I mean, we didn't have good windows. I mean, mm-hmm. we had the door open all the time, mm-hmm. and had a lot of and drafts, and the same with the apartment buildings. I had my window open a lot. The doors were open a lot, and mm-hmm. still had these higher levels. So I just couldn't believe it. I really mm-hmm. was shocked that we got these high tests. Mm-hmm. Now, when you are doing your job and go around, you went to the TRP and did a lecture there, mm-hmm. and then you probably go to places a lot in this time of year, don't you?
Yeah, winter's the best time to test for radon, so we typically encourage people all over the state to test. And that's why we give out free radon test kits in January and February each year, so that they can do that. Douglas County has a radon potential about 40%. So that means that of the people that have tested, 40% of them have a radon issue. And I know you mentioned that, your home was drafty and you have the windows open. Typically, that's not enough to lower the radon level below the action level.
That's why I was shocked. It didn't make any sense. Like, I was giving the same speech to a neighbor. He says, it's an old house, it's drafty, and I couldn't get him to do a kit.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna still gonna give him a kit anyways, just to get him on the, But anyways, if you're living in Douglas County, can you still get free kits at the
extension office?
Yeah.
So the test kits are free until the end of February. In Douglas County, they used to be free all year around, but the county can't afford to pay for that all year around anymore because of budget cuts. And so if you want to get a kit, you want to stop by Extension office in Douglas County or our partner offices between now and February 29th.
Excellent. Well, you can still buy them for a pretty nominal fee,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, like they're only $10.
Yeah. $10, so mm-hmm. if you get a free one, fine. If you can't get a free one, it's worth $10 because mm-hmm. you wouldn't want to know my expenses I had with lung cancer. It was not a good time. Not to mention your loss of income, but you can also lose a lot of time on your health. Mm-hmm. Also, for kids, I think I read someplace that it's like if you have a radon problem, it's like smoking half a pack of cigarettes a day, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what the risk is like if you're just at the action level. There's greater risk at higher levels of radon. So just at the action level, which is 4 picocuries per liter of air, it's like you're smoking about half a pack of cigarettes a day. I don't have the calculations for higher than that, but it's like action level onward, you want to fix it. So it's like, let's not talk about how much more risk it is. Just fix the problem.
That's what I think. Fix the problem, and then it's not the problem. Also, I live in South Lake Tahoe. The percentage of problems up in Tahoe is a lot higher than it is in the valley. Was it as high as 68% or 70%? I forget the exact numbers.
I think it depends on what parts of Tahoe you're talking about.
It didn't say on there. It said unexplained.
Yeah, so there's parts. Since it's a Nevada radon education program, we only have information for Nevada. And you can see how it's all red here. And on the other side, it's also red. So the Nevada side of Tahoe is called State Line. And the radon potential there is about 66% of the homes tested have a radon issue. And on the California side, it's also elevated. So you could expect that you'd find chances of elevated levels to be similar.
Well, the California person that represents radon for El Dorado County, did she say where they have radon kits at? Because the only place I know of is Sue Novacell. And she's the El Dorado County supervisor.
So other places would include if you went to TRPA. If you're here locally, you could stop by. They have California test kits that we've received from Natalia Deardroff. She's the radon person for California.
Oh, I didn't know she drops them off there. Great.
Yeah, actually, we got them from her and we dropped them off there. So there are some California test kits there if you wanted one.
Excellent. Yeah. I did not know that because last time you gave me some because I had lung cancer and mm-hmm. I made sure they got out and about. Mm-hmm. Well, that's fantastic. So on your job going around telling people, what else can we get them for information? How can they, I have a EPA guide, and I don't know what people are wanting when they see you. Do they want the basic stuff that you have, or can they see this on your website or somehow?
Yeah, so our brochures are typically not on our website, but the information's available there as well. So we have the basic radon information brochure that talks about radon's health risk, how to test for radon, how to fix a radon problem, where to get a radon test kit. They also have this radon real estate guide that people can contact us for. If they go to radonnv.com, that's where all of our information is located. And there's information for Nevada specifically, and then there's national information. So if you're thinking, what about if I have a radon problem in another state, you can find information there. You can also call our hotline, which is 888-RADON-10, and we'll get a hold of information that you need. If you don't find somebody on the website and you have questions, we can answer those through the hotline.
Yeah, because they say 21,000 Americans die of radon-caused lung cancer, and that's a terrible figure. When I was living in Michigan, my best friend's dad died of lung cancer, and he was a non-smoker, and we didn't have any idea how he got lung cancer, but, there's always ways of preventing things that hurt your health, and this is one area you should get involved in, especially if you live in the basin. But, the high, I guess Douglas County itself is a pretty high area. Yeah. You live in Reno, don't you?
Yeah.
What's the level there?
So in Washoe County, where I live, the chances of a radon issue are about 22% of the homes tested. So it's about 1 in 5 homes that are tested have a radon problem. And then to go back to what you're saying about the number of people that die each year from lung cancer caused by radon, if you're not a smoker, radon's going to be the primary way that you get lung cancer. So if you're not a smoker, this is an issue you want to address because it's the leading cause of lung cancer for you. And if you are a smoker, it's the second leading cause. So even for smokers, it can be an issue. So if you know any smokers or you are a smoker, you're going to want to test for the gas and reduce the level in your home if you have an elevated level.
Well, I think that says it all. Your contact again?
Yeah, if you have any questions, you can call our radon hotline, and that's 888-RADON-10. And also you can visit our website, which is radonnv.com.
Did you want to give out your number?
Sure. So, they can't see the card. Oh, okay. Sorry about that. So you can't see the font. So my number is going to be 775-336-0252. Again, that number is 775-336-0252. And that's my desk number if you have any questions. And so, yeah, there's that.
Well, thank you, Nadia, for being on Health Talk.
Yeah.
It's been Michael Smith for Health Talk. And don't wait till your family has a serious problem. At least get your house checked. And, mm-hmm. 40% chance if you had that in for gambling. I would take that for gambling. So now you're, it's a good chance you have it if you're in Douglas County, especially if you're in the basin. So get mitigated and at least get yourself checked. Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Yeah.